Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we are back this week. Kingdoms of Amalur Reckoning on the PC. Last time, we explored a pretty good chunk of Twilight Pass after clearing out the Shadow Pass of the commander that was there. And now we gotta go ahead and find all these Witch Knights, one who is down here, and one who it looks like is actually in Bale itself. So we're gonna have fun with that. So let's get to it then, shall we? And hopefully we don't get as many sprite ambushes as we've been getting here. I think you're dead, so I'm not gonna go after you. Yeah, I think we killed that guy last episode. And yeah, everything's just gonna get meteored here pretty much. Let's see if we can't get a few more of you guys here. There you go, there's three. And there you go, come on guys, there you go. I wanna go ahead and get you guys all damage boosted. Get you guys all nice and together like that. There you go. There we go. Come on, get him. There you go. And how about a nice Mark of Flame? Beautiful. Not quite the meteor I had in mind, but you know what? It worked out just as well. Okay, looks like I got my greater damage boost back. They're not going to let me get rid of all of those. Like, ever. Prisoner Plum. Alright, and you're trash. That kind of looks like a tightrope wire on the mini-map here. Kinda. Alright, so we got another pile of rocks, another chest. That's going to jump down, so I'm not going to worry about that yet. But let's grab those while we're here. Trash. I tried those damn scepters, but they just don't do anything for damage. It's just sad. Merciless Chakrams. That's actually not that bad. I could just dismantle that for something. Now, is the jump point over here? Because that's what it looks like. No, it's right here. Okay. So it's jumping down into here. Okay. Just wanted to make sure. So let's see, we got a whole bunch of zealots, and a whole bunch of zealots. We're probably just going to go ahead and clobber everything here. Let's see, where's our nearest fast travel? Right there. I'm thinking real fast that I want to go and do something real fast. Where is the nearest alchemy? Here we go. Let's do this real fast, because I don't want to forget. Let's see. Get rid of that, since we don't really need it. And that. And let's see. Let's go ahead and see what I can put on here. I want to put on... Are you already mapped there, the Master Precision? Yeah, you are. Okay. Let's see, I'm looking for something in particular. If I have it, if not, I'm going to go make some. Alright, Steeled Curtain, I don't really care about that. Warrior Strength, I don't care about that. Okay, I was hoping that I would have some Blazing Solve potions, but if I don't, I'm going to make some right now, because that would actually be reasonably useful for having all this fire stuff that I'm doing here. Let's see. Alright, Blazing Solves. That does require Essences of Fate, which is unfortunate. But if we go for the Journeyman, it doesn't require it. So let's go ahead and make a couple of these. Yeah, 20% extra, 50% fire damage, an extra 20 fire damage total versus... Yeah, you get an extra 25%. You know, I'm not going to use the Essences of Fate for too much anyway, so let's make three of those, and then the rest will just be the greater variety here. Alright, there we go. Perfect. That way we have something nice for big groups, so we just want an extra clobber. Alright, so let's see. Where are you guys at? Alright, greater Blazing Solve. I'll put that. And then just to have them if we need them. The master blazing solves. There we go. Alright, now let's go ahead and head back over here. And it's a little further away than I would have liked. But you know what? We'll live. We can just make a mad dash for freedom and we'll be okay. Glad to see there's music in this area, because sometimes they like to go for the whole ambient occlusion thing and not have any music whatsoever. Alright, you guys will have to go down after we get to this little path. It looks like you should be able to get down there, but can't jump unless there's a little ledge. Hello, everybody. Got you. I want to get a nice group of you guys so I can extra meteor you guys. That'd be great. Alright, let's go ahead with the blazing salve. There we go. And let's go ahead with a nice meteor of death. Yeah, I don't think you guys stood a chance. Sorry there, Mr. Essence of Fate, or whatever you're doing there. You are too late, as usual. It's just what you do. Alright, good. We were able to get the Theodon's Charge. I wasn't sure if we were, because it looks kind of dilapidated, and there's a corpse hanging on it that I just now noticed. There was something over here that I was going to grab. Ah, there we go. You. Curse of Obliterating. Ooh, extra 35% physical damage. That's actually not bad, but we can't get that off of there and onto a different piece of armor, so it's mildly useless, which is unfortunate, but oh well. Alright, now let's see. There is our Witch Knight. So let's get to him then, shall we? No, okay, nothing over there, so we're going to be fine right here. And you know what? Might as well. Why not? Do I have to talk to him? Oh, I do. No, not you. There you go. Talk to him. You're great. Okay. That's kind of stupid that I'm supposed to talk to him, but it won't let me. Therefore, it's just, not working. Okay. That worked out easy enough, I guess. Alright, that works. Okay, failed. Got it that time. Okay, good. Emperor's Staff. Extra health, which I don't really need. Trash. Okay, got you. What else we got here? Anything besides another... Oh, no, the shrine is downstairs. Well, it's nice to know that we have the alchemy up here instead of just downstairs like I thought it was. If I can find my way out. There we go. I got lost in here somehow. Those Blazing Solve potions do not last for too terribly long. I'm guessing this jump point will just take us to where we were when we got ambushed by the sprites. Yeah, I'm not... Or the Echoing Light Mine. Yeah, I'm not really worried about that. So let's just continue on our merry little path here, shall we? Okay, I guess that guy's not actually in Bale. Like, it looks like he's just on the very edge of the map there. Okay. I thought he was actually going to have to wait till the last area of the game to go find him. Which would have been mildly irritating, but we could have dealt with it. Eventually. Now, let's see. To the right goes towards Amaura, which is the final area of the game. We really are going through these final zone really fast. It's kind of ridiculous, actually. Okay, stop it. I want to go ahead and... There we go. Is anybody still alive? No? Perfect. Fantastic. I like that combo of Force Potion and Salve. It does wonders for their complexions. Gives them that nice charcoal briquette feeling. Or look to it or whatever. Alright. And whirlpool, whirlpool. And we have to go all the way back over there. Okay, let's grab that. Why not? It'll be a slight little bit of backtracking, but I think we'll live. Yeah, I don't have any use for the bones. But you know what? Eh, trash it. Why not? Since it won't let me dash past until I grab them. You know, you do a surprisingly graceful little splash into the water there, fella. If you're not careful, a dive like that could actually hurt. I remember when I was little, I tried, Urgle's Luxurious Legwear. That's pretty cool. Oh, that's, nice. That's I think that's part of the, well, obviously part of the, what is it? Master, or not Master of None, Jack of All Trades. That's nice, though. And I think we have most of the set there, but I'm probably not going to do a spec like that, just for the fact that, like I said, you're not going to be able to get to a fair amount of the good stuff. You'll be stuck with all the lower tier stuff, like basic Mark of Flame and lightning bolts and stuff like that for magic, and then you won't have the really good physical spells from Might or anything. So it's a neat concept, but I think it works better just being specced into one and with a little bit of points in another. You should be able to save like a template of your specialization. That way you can just play, oh, I want to go back to this one, especially since I'm at max level here. This way I can just go to a Fate Weaver and just switch out between saved abilities. Okay, don't want to go over there. But I guess that would make it a little too convenient, I suppose. Hello. Alright, you don't have anybody to shield you this time. Alright, get you. Gotcha. You. Thank you. Yeah, last time, this little bastard took all the hits for that guy, and I couldn't kill him. Oh, by last time, I mean down here somewhere. I don't remember exactly, but you get the general idea. Yeah, let's see. Now, do I gotta talk to you guys again or no? No? It looks like no. Okay, there's a lot of zealots here, which is not what I want to deal with. Ooh, hello. Let's go ahead and damage, salve, and wait for these guys to get close, and meteor. Okay, there we go. Hopefully he's not protected by his little magic circle, and that'll just clobber him. Fantastic. It worked. Beautiful. I love it. Thank you. You had something, but then it disappeared. I don't know what happened there. I swear I saw a glowing light from your body like you had something, but then it just kind of adiosed itself. Oh well, I'm not too concerned about it. And I'm guessing that the Mage Knight is dead. Oh, there's Gask right there. So yeah, we'll be able to get to him in just a moment. Some guy was smart enough to stay over there, not get involved in the slaughtering. So he was smart. Glad for him. What do we got over here? Nothing, just an empty cage for us to not want to be any part of. Thank you, and there's the pile of rocks, sir. And I see you there. There you go. Easy enough. No. I wonder if we can pull, like, all these guys into a nice, just little combustible circle of death there. That'd be actually really nice. Kadsimir, okay. Oh, and we got a nice little fast travel point to the end of the area. Nice. Yeah, come on over this way, guys. I want to kind of get you guys all for one and one for all and all that good stuff. There we go. Alright, let's defend here for a minute. See if we can't just get everybody kind of grouped up. That'd be great. Let's go over here. That way the archer has to walk around. Or not. Okay. Okay, the archer just kind of gave up. You know what? We'll live. And you know what? Let's just go ahead and start with the meteor festivities here. Anybody that feels like surviving that is fine. Oh, there's Gask. You know what? Before I kill you, I want to get this little bastard. Ow. Come here, you little shit. Alright, there we go. Now let's get Gask. And let's go ahead and lightning bolt him here. Oh, he's got plenty of health, it looks like. Nice. And how about a nice thunderstorm there? Beautiful. Gotcha. Unfortunately, the AI decided to not want to let me kite him all the way to Mr. Gask there, but oh well. We did good enough. Fervor. Nice one-handed sword, it looks like. I want to see what that looks like. Hello, Arctic Staff. Sure, why not? It said massive for a one-hander. That is not that big. Eh, oh well. Now, is that NPC going to try to run all the way to me? Yes, he is. He's going to marathon himself all the way down here to talk to me. Just before I get to that chest, watch. Or he might just wait there. That'd be great. But those guys really haul ass once they figured out, hey, the guy that I was afraid of is dead. Like, they get freaking Olympic level speed. And I'm getting Olympic levels of greater damage boost here. No, he's just going to stay there. Okay, so let's just meet him over there.
Welcome back. You're back. I was keeping an eye on you from a safe distance to see if you would keep your promise. I am amazed. I dared not speak of it, but there are prophecies of a mortal who would herald our kind's passing. While the defeat of Gask will count as a victory against the madness of Gadflow, I wonder if it is a harbinger of darker nights ahead. Prophecies aside, you have done as I asked, and we, the Clan of Ashmore, recognize you.
Well, glad to hear it.
Farewell.
And thanks for not giving me any reward, you cheap bastard. Oh well. We're not getting any quests for these caves here, which is kind of weird. Unless we get to Amaura and they just throw a bunch at us, which might be the case. I don't know. Because if we don't get any quests for them, we're going to have to explore them all on screen or off screen or something. Probably on screen, since, like I said, they have the autumn stones in them. Or a couple of them do, at least. But yeah, no one around here really cares for the cave system that they got going on around here. Okay, I have no quest, so let's just go for Vengeance, since, you know, that's the one going forward. There you go. And let's just head straight into Amaura, which I think is the name of a Pokemon in X and Y, I think. Or something very similar to that, I do believe. Hello. Hello. Okay, you're way down there. Let's see. Swad, soldier, trolls. Okay, let's get these guys. Why not? Oh, hello. Okay, damn mages. I don't want to deal with you. Go. Oh, wait. Damn it. Okay, you guys. Just about dead. There you go. Fantastic. The mage ran away. I don't know why, but he decided he didn't want to be any. He didn't want any part of this for some reason. There you go. Make it. Come on, you're not dying anywhere near fast enough there, fella. Why are you so resistant to everything? Why do you do this to me? There we go. That worked. Widowmaker's Scepter. Extra damage versus humans, which probably isn't going to be that helpful around here, since it's mostly going to be Tuatha and possibly some Fae and Sprites. Well, lots of Sprites for whatever reason. I guess it's because there's a high concentration of magic in the area. That's my guess, but still, there's too many of them around here. You. Goodbye. You're not getting up your little shield. Go away. If you do get up your shield, it's not going to be for long. Thank you. I hate you little bastards. Ah, thank you. And there is a shrine over there. Altar of Balin. Have we seen that one before? I don't know if we have. Let's find out. Yeah, I got a nice little corpse hanging on there. And we're just about to enter Amaura here. Death's Touch. Okay, we've seen this before. What does it do? Chance to steal health, I do believe. Yeah, there we go. That's not too shabby. I like that. This final area is not very long. It seemed like a lot of the beginning areas were too long for their own good, and then some of the later areas barely have anything in them for some reason. At least that's what it seems like. Seems like there should be something back here, but no, you can't get back there. And I'm expecting an ambush at any moment here. No, I guess not. Okay. Let's see, Amora Stone. Yeah, there are Amora Stones we got to deal with here. Let's see. Whole bunch of Tuatha priests and zealots here. And there's our rendezvous point. So let's go ahead and meet up here. Ooh, hello. You know what? Let's just go ahead and get you guys out of the way real fast. Ah, the troll was nice enough to move into our line of fire here. And for a second it looked like my little partner was dead, but I don't think he is. There you go. Yeah, how about another, you know what, let's go for a blizzard on you. There you go, take that. There we go. Beautiful. Yeah, it's working out decent enough. There you go. That worked out.
My guard will not be far behind you. Neither of us saw any sign of Aelin Shear or Ventrinu. A scout on the ridge above saw the Tuatha mounting for a counterattack. You should hear what he has to say before we move on. If you'd rather not wait, talk with Agar. Time is of the essence.
I saw, what is it, Aelin Shear and Ventrinio a couple areas ago.
Agar, if he tells you he's ready, then my people are as well. Of course, if you wish to proceed with caution, the scout on the ridge will know what we're up against.
Get all right.
This is worse than I feared.
Let's see, grab these real fast. And if Agarth ever shows up, well, awesome. If he doesn't, well, we'll live. Ah, there's Agarth. I want this dead body here, that'd be great.
There you are.
Hush. And right here, there we go. Crap. Not bad. Yay, repair kits. You know what? I'm actually gonna see how my stuff is doing, and I can actually use it. So, why not? Let's see that. Oh, that's definitely low. Anything else? No, everything else is good. Alright, beautiful. Now, any other items that I missed here? No, okay. Let's talk to Agarth then. Actually, you said you had a scout,
let's
right?
Let's drive these red-eyed bastards into the ground.
Calm down there, Squeaky.
Good to see you here. Ready?
Sure.
I am. But there hasn't been any sign of Aelin Shear or Ventrinio. Damn it all, I knew we couldn't trust her.
Yeah, maybe it's not her fault.
I sent Ventrinio to keep an eye on her. He was sending me messages until recently. But there were fewer and fewer as we've gotten closer to Bale. We need to get through the House of Vengeance and kill the Kerr. And we'll have to do it without them.
And who's the Kerr?
He's the closest thing Vengeance has to a leader anymore. A face so consumed with hatred that he's little more than a beast. If you're going to get into Bale, the Kerr has to die.
Okay. Alright. We should wait for her.
No. Whatever Gadflo is doing in there, it's growing with every wasted minute. Even if Aelin didn't betray us, we don't have time to wait. Listen, you're more powerful than I ever was. If anyone can stop this, it's you. When you kill Kerr, go into Bale and stop Gadflo. If we get separated, we'll keep fighting to keep an escape route open for you. Now go. Stay on guard.
Okay. So, we gotta conquer the House of Vengeance. Alright, you know what? We're gonna go ahead and do that next time. So, guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good night.